Hi, and thanks for logging on to the Daily Dvarin. Here's a brand new halacha for you, and it's for Thursday, the 10th day of May. Here we go. It's Lag BaOmer on Thursday, the 10th of May. I want to tell you a little bit more about this special day. We've already explained to you that it is the day of the passing of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, a great tzaddik, a great mystic, an incredibly wise Jewish man who taught tremendous amounts of Kabbalistic wisdom and more to the Jewish world, and we mark this day, the day that he revealed all this wisdom to the world, with unusual festivities as he requested. One of the things that people do is they visit the site of his burial in Meron. They actually pray there for things like finding a shidduch, finding a person to marry, and to all kinds of things. Tens of thousands of people will show up at his burial site. I want to tell you a fascinating story about Reb Shem Bar Yochai in his lifetime. At one point, it had happened that the Romans were after him, and he had to hide in a cave studying Torah with his son. And when he learned Torah there, it was in total seclusion, away from the eyes of the entire world. It was even miraculous how they sustained themselves. Well, anyway, at the end of 12 years, when they came out from that intensive Torah study, it had been such a powerful situation that when it happened that they left, the gaze of Reb Shem Bar Yochai, just him looking at ordinary people just chilling out, whereas he had been so incredibly spiritual, his gaze could almost kill people when he looked at them because of the intense holiness that he had experienced. God was not pleased with that, so God actually told Reb Shem Bar Yochai to go back into the cave. He had spent 12 years there studying in intensity, and he was sort of kind of too intense to come back into the world. After one more year of study in the cave, God again told him it's safe now to come out of the cave, and when he came out that time, the problem no longer happened. Now, that needs some explaining, because if he'd gone back into the cave and studied with even greater intensity, you would expect that he would come out and be even more kind of like dangerous to the world because of the great intensity of his holiness. But we learn an incredible thing from this story. As he ramped up in increased holiness, that increase in holiness brought him to that next level where the holiness was actually workable with the people around him. And that came with the higher level of holiness that he had attained. Now, none of this really, really applies to us because we're not anywhere near any of these leagues, but it does teach us an incredibly important lesson, and that is, yes, you too, and I, we should try to be holy, separate ourselves away from all pleasures that we should not be indulging in, etc., and allow ourselves in a proper way to have the pleasures that God does allow us. But the thing is, when you become that holy, don't make it such that you're so intense that you annoy everyone around you and insult everyone around you because they're not at your level. That's not the way God intends holiness to be. As a matter of fact, some rabbis like to hang it on the words, Anshei Kodesh Tihi Only. Be not just holy, but Anshei Kodesh. And that kind of means people holy. Menschlich holy, you know, holy to the point where everyone around you can take it and you can share it with them. That's the kind of holiness that God wants from us. Thanks for logging on. Log on again tomorrow for more. Bye-bye.